This is what sawing with a slack blade, and you forget to tension it. The first week of learning the sawmill comes to an end. Although the week has ended, the learning has not, and never will. The first order of business is to replace the blade I cut into the steel log stop with. I watched a man on YouTube hold one of these up. Not quite that way, I guess. Gotta go the other way. I think I'd better look at that particular video again. I definitely see a battery-powered leaf blower in my future. Oh, there's another thing I was going to do.
That's windshield washer fluid to prevent freezing.
Even smells like orange soda pop.
Gotta get some gravel in here one of these days. Been saying that for years.
Unfinished business, sawing the rest of the redwood into slabs. This time, I'll turn the flat side down. Put a scrap of board under the cant hook to avoid marring the slab surface. My supervisor lends a hand.
Glad I'm not going to be doing anything heavy like this again. At least I don't think I am. At least not anytime soon.
I made several sacrificial log stops.
Not as strong as steel, but on the upside, they're not as strong as steel. Right down here for now. Because we are using these, and we're not going any lower than 2 inches, so we can bring them up one.
They're up an inch and a half. I marked them incorrectly.
One there, one right here, and we are good to go. Except for one little thing. We don't have a saw blade on here yet. And that seems kind of important. What we have here is a brand new blade, fresh out of the box, and carefully wiped down with a rag to get the preservative off it. Before we do that, yeah, can adjust that down to a drop a day if I wanted to, and it would drip on the blade, not dribble down the hardware. So we got that. First thing we do is put the gloves back on. I have heard that some blades are shipped inside out. That is, with the teeth pointed the wrong direction, and you have to reverse them. Not the case here. It feels like the right position. You won't know until it's tensioned. There is correct tension. Yeah, it's right where it should be. This is the last of the redwood. I'll cut it into narrow strips and reduce them to 3/4-inch stickers on the table saw. Stickers separate lumber for airflow while drying. I have another minor issue. What we've got now is, I've just noticed, this track clearing cable is too far this way, and this one doesn't have room to get between the wheel and the track. Well, the reason this isn't going anywhere is buried in the sawdust on the other side is a lock nut. Okay. It's all chewed up. Right about there. Now there's nothing in the manual about any way to adjust the internal clutch on this winch. I can crank it up easily. Cranking it down is more than my surgically modified shoulder can tolerate. So I need to loosen that up. So this last 12-foot redwood is all that's left. These are too small to mess with, so all of this will become firewood. Going to get a scale and see how much power it takes, how much force, how many pounds at the end of that crank handle it takes, because it's more than I can manage. ¢25. Okay. I need to call wood of the mill, find out if that's what it's supposed to be. All these, gonna cut up short, then go to the table saw and shape them to 3/4 by 3/4 stickers. Come up here and fix all this wood pile. I didn't make stickers that day. I didn't want to run such wet wood through my table saw. So I stacked the rough stickers loosely in the basement with fans blowing through them. The next morning, I was back at the sawmill. Oops, I forgot to replace the gas cap. You've been waiting for this, haven't you? The blade came off the wheels and hit that yellow blade guard. I thought the blade hit the guard and jumped off the wheel, but I realized much later that hitting the guard was the result, not the cause of the blade coming off the wheels. The blade didn't break, and aside from a few dull teeth, appeared undamaged.
Aha! Teeth are hitting the bent guard.
I do not know why this is dragging. As soon as I pushed it in, tension was correct. The first time I ran the blade without tensioning it first, it gouged that a little bit, but not like that. I think I'm going to run that without this. Seems to serve no useful purpose. We will see.
The blade guard retainer knob has to be in place, even with the guard removed. If the knob is not in there, water drips out that hole instead of on the blade.
Here's the cut before it threw the blade, and here it is after. There are teeth out of line, one at least.
The blade was still sharp enough, and the boards didn't have to be pretty. So I kept it on the sawmill so I'd make any further mistakes on an already damaged blade. The next video in this series will include all the modifications and fixes I've applied so far, with particular attention to that stiff winch. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.